number 16. The following particulars are obtained from the books of Sunshine Limited for the year ended 31st December 2012. Purchase of materials 42,500, productive wages 32,500, unproductive wages 3,000, motive power 2,000, loose tools written off 250, chargeable expenses 2,500, carriage inwards 650, reserve for bad debts 1,600, bad debts 500, telephone charges 200, work stationery 750, material sold as scrap 350, sale of scrap factory 150, loss by fire material 1,800, carriage outwards 1,100, debt collection charges 220, office expenses 4,800, showroom rent 400, welfare service 1,000, haulage 325, water supply 125, estimating expenses 625, rectification cost of defective 75, samples and free gifts 650, upkeep of delivery van 400, commission on sales 625, warehouse rent 445, stock beginning 1112 5500, material work in process 7500, finished goods value 27,000, finished goods units 1,500, stock 31st 12 material 1,500, work in process 6,500, finished goods nil, finished goods units 500. So 6,000 units are sold at rupee 40 per unit. Prepare a cost statement showing components of cost per unit and profits. Closing stock of finished goods is to be valued at current year's factory cost. So this is these are the informations related to the accounting year 2012. That is a cost data relating to the year 2012. So we are asked to prepare a cost sheet with units, total cost, cost per unit. Name of the unit is here Sunshine Limited. So let us start this. Sunshine Limited. Title is Sunshine Limited. Cost sheet. For the year ending 31st December 2012. Here, total units or units produced during the year. So it is given that 6,000 units are sold. So 6,000 units are sold. Units is equal to units sold, 6,000 sold, plus closing stock, finished goods 500, plus 500 stock, less opening stock 1,500 opening stock. Opening stock. So is equal to 5,000. So units produced here is 5,000 units. So units produced, we have to calculate. How to calculate the units produced? First of all, take the sales. Sales Then to that add the closing stock of finished goods 6500. From this deduct the opening stock. You will get the output or the goods produced during the year. Total units produced during the year. Total units produced. Total units produced. So now units column, total cost column, cost per unit column, cost per unit column. Cost of materials consumed, first of all, cost of materials consumed, opening stock of material is 5,500. Plus purchases to this, purchases 42,500. Then we add carriage inward means here carrying charges while purchasing, carriage inward 650. Then all these add, you will get 50, 11, 6, 16, 18, so 486,000, sorry, 48,650, 48,650. From this deduct less closing stock 1,500, closing stock of material is 1,500. Then material lost by fire, again deduct material lost by fire, lost is 1,800. Then again less material sold as scrap, material sold as scrap is 350. So all these are deducted. 2000 these 50, 8, 11, 1, 7. So fifty, 11, 16, 1. So the answer is 5,000 units manufactured. Unit cost is 9 rupees. Then chargeable expenses means here direct expense. Under that, chargeable expense is 2,500 per unit 55. Then again, direct wage is product two, unproductive unproductive user, we have to take care productive wage. 32,500. So it is 6 rupees 65 paisa. So add this, you will get the prime cost. Prime cost 5,000 units produced, 80,000. This is total is 80,000. Then 16 rupees. And factory overheads. Factory overheads. One is unproductive wage. Unproductive wages 3,000. Motive power 2,000. Then loose tools written off 250. Work stationery 750. Then haulage, another expense. Haulage means here internal transport system. So internal transport cost. Haulage 325. Then water supply 125. Estimating charges or expenses 625. Welfare services 1,000. Rectification cost of defectives, all these are factory expenses. Rectification cost of defective. Rectification cost of defective 75. So total is 8,150. From this, if there is sale of scrap, opening stock of work in progress, then closing stock of work in progress are to be adjusted. So less sale of scrap, it is 150. Then closing work in progress $5,500. So these are to be deducted. Then the total of this is 6,650. Then to this, so 6,650 deduct. then to this plus opening work in progress. Opening work in progress 7500. So closing work in progress 5500. So out of 8150, deduct 150, 8000. From 8000, deduct 5500, it is 2500. So this is 2500. So plus opening stock of work in progress 7500. The net amount is 10,000. Per unit is 2 rupees. So therefore, factory cost. Factory cost. 5,000 units manufactured. Then 90,000 is the total cost. Then 18 rupees is the cost per unit. Now we add office overheads to this. Office overheads. One is telephone charge. Telephone charge 200. Then office expenses 4,800. Total it is 5,000. Per unit 1. So now the total is 5,000 units, 95,019 rupees. Then plus opening stock of finished goods. Yeah, the opening stock of finished goods is 1500 units. Rate. If the value is given, you take the value. Opening stock of finished goods value is given 27,000. Take that value 27,000. So here we need not calculate this. Now 3,500. Then if you deduct 27,000 from this amount, you will get 8, here is 6, 68,000. 68,000, leave it, value is 19 rupees, same value. Then the less closing stock of finished goods. Closing stock of finished goods is, so this is add, sorry, 6,500. So here it is also, it is added. Opening stock is added. So 1,22,000. Less closing stock of finished goods 500 units. Value is not given. Always take the current rate. Again, we are asked to take what rate? Closing stock of finished goods is to be valued at current year's factory cost. Here the current year's factory cost is 18 rupees. This we are asked to take this value.
18 rupees. So here 500 into 18 rupees. 500 into 18 rupees is equal to 9,000. So now the value. If you deduct 6,000, then 1,22,000 minus 9,000 is equal to 1,13,000. Then the value cost. Actually, we have to take the 19 rupees. The current rate is, after adding office expenses, etc., 19 rupees. Then we will get the cost of sales. Therefore, cost of sales. Then to this add selling and distribution expenses. Here all the selling and distribution expenses. Selling and distribution expenses one by one. One is here, carriage outward. Carriage outward is, that is the carrying charges incurred at the time of sale. So carriage inward at the time of purchase, carriage outward at the time of sale. Carriage outward 100. Then debt collection charges. Debt collection charge amounting to 230. Then showroom rent, again selling expense, showroom rent. It is 400. Then samples and free gifts. Sample and free gifts, 550. Then upkeep of delivery van, it is 400. Commission on sales. Commission on sales 625. Then warehouse rent. $445. Bad debt. $500. So totaling $3,250. 54. This is the total cost. Therefore, total cost 6,000 units sold. 1,16,000. 250. Then 19.38. Then sales. About the sales, the given information is sales sales. 6,000 units were sold at rupee 40 per unit. Sales 40 per unit. 40 into 6,000. 2,40,000. 6,000. So now you get the unit cost. Sorry, unit profit. Therefore, profit. Here the unit profit is 40 minus 90. 40 minus 20 means here 20. Here 0.38 means 19.60. So 38 20.62 is the profit. 62 is the profit. Then profit per unit is 1,23,750. 1,23,750 is the per unit profit. So here reserve for bad debt is a financial item, non-cost item. And this is how the cost sheet is.